friends, welcome to Sinu Technologies. Myself Ram Kumar. So we will know more about Object Studio. So in our previous video we have seen how to launch an application, how to terminate application with a specific condition to it, right? So we will just go behind it and then we will try to enter some data and then we will try to enter the URL and then we will see how we can retrieve a HTML data. Let's go back to the tool. Okay? So before terminate we want to do that logic of entering the URL and then get the HTML page, read some specific section in a page or anything you can read from a page. So before doing that, what I would recommend is you should go through the manual thing once, means what are the steps involved. So what you will do once a browser is opened, so where you click, how you enter the URL and then where you say enter. You have to do it something manually once so that you will understand this, how to configure it here in the tool. So let's do it that way. So I am opening the browser. Once the browser is opened, if you see here, about blank is highlighted and then I'll click here and then it is, the cursor is blinking here. If I type the URL now, so it is something like, it is a problem if you can see, right? So this will not work. So once the about blank is there, you need to do a select all, which is Control A, and then now you have to type the URL, right? So I will use something called weather report, world weather. So once you select the URL or when you type the URL and hit enter, the page gets loaded and then we will try to read this section, local weather section here. That's what we will target for this, right? So this is how it is there. So we have got the steps now. I am closing the browser. So what we do is we have to use the navigate button and then you have to click first on the browser URL section. That's what we need to do. So let's say we can give the name as click browser URL. This is our action. So this is, see, to this is the action name we have kept. But what is asking for, what is the HTML element where you want to do a click? So this is the input browser URL we have configured earlier, right? So let's use it and then we will select the action as global mouse click center. Means it will hit on the, click on the center of the section which we have identified, right? And then I will say OK. So once we clicked on it, what we have done something called Control A. So Control A is something like, it's a global keys which we are doing. Means when the cursor is on the window or this particular HTML element, once you type in the browser or when you type in on the keyword, it will get input onto the section which is the cursor is available, right? So if you take the input browser URL and then try to type it, there is no, like, the action is not there, means the global send keys are not there. All clicks related actions are there because these are not available at HTML level in GroupRhythm. So this will be enabled for the parent only, right? So when you pull the parent here, similar to launch and terminate, if you drag this browser Google part and then when you say global send keys, this is what you will be having. Okay, so now in this text you can give what the value which you want to type. So I have the URL ready, so I will just copy paste here. So the same thing will be typed in. So this is what is enter URL. Okay, so enter URL is what we are doing. So say okay. Next enter URL, what we have done, we have clicked on enter, right? Let me give the values enter, same I will use the global send keys and then I will say enter. So this is a command for enter. So I will give you the list of commands which we have so that it will, the bot will be performing in a similar way. Okay, so enter, we have to give, this is the syntax for enter. So after enter, what you should do, you should wait for the page to load and then you should terminate. Are we missing anything? So click browser URL, enter URL. Between this, we missed one step. If you remember, what we thought is we have to do a Control A. So Control A is to select all means the text which is defaultly there in the browser URL should be selected all, and then you should type the URL. So I'll use the global send keys again, and then I will say for control A we have, this is the command, caret A means control A. Similarly we have for shift A, alt buttons, we have other commands. I will tell you later. At this moment we are doing a control A. So this is, we will give the stage name as select all. So this is the thing. So let me quickly link this, and then so before it, after it enters the URL and click on enter, there will be something getting loaded onto the page, but we are immediately saying terminate it. So there is a chance that the browser will be closed, right? For that what I will do is I will use a breakpoint to terminate, means before terminating stop the process. So the browser URL will be entered, and then we will see what is the page getting loaded. That is the intention here. Okay, let's run this flow now. So the browser is getting launched, a blank A, control A, URL typed, enter. If you see here, breakpoint reached. We can go back and see what is the page loaded. If you see here, the page got loaded here, and then we have this section. We want to read this section, so we need to spy this. We have not spied this, right? So let us spy this element quickly. So for that we have not terminated, so the application is still attached. So you can open the application modular and then add the element here. So this is my application page. So what I will do is I will add, see this is inside the window, right? So I will try to add it as a child to this. So you can add it to as an element, you can add it as a child, no issues. It's all depends upon you actually. So what I want to do, I want to read the weather. I want to read report something, right? I will do a identify. So default is HTML mode. If you see here, I don't see when I'm hovering on New York, it comes one by one, but I want to read all. New York 41 degrees clear or not, I want to read all. So I will select the parent section like this, and then I will say control plus left click should be done together. And now if you see here, so the empty ones I am removing because of no use. There is no point in keeping a condition which the values are empty, right? So these are the five elements attributes which will make it unique, which I am thinking. I am saying apply, highlight. If you see here, so let me go back to the page, and on top of this I will say highlight. So it is getting highlighted. Okay, so our what we have done is right. So I will say okay. Now I will go back to my object studio. So I have something called extra, added one more element to it where I can read it. So let me move this down so that I can use the read operator. So we have a HTML element now. Earlier once was window, now we have a HTML element. For HTML element we can use read stage. So let me read this, read report, right? So read report is this which we have used now. So let me pull the element here. If you see, this is a HTML element. So now it is saying get HTML. It's not using click here. If you see, clicks are for windows. We are seeing get document, get HTML element, so many things are there. So I'll be saying get HTML. This is what we want. And then what we want to do is we want to store that thing in a HTML data variable. So I am creating it by clicking on the icon. It got created. So okay. So we have the thing now. I am linking the things, and then again we will see what is coming here, or we can see that we can terminate the process also. So I will remove the thing, and then we will see what the data is needed once the process is completed or the flow is completed, right? So I am just moving it up, and then let's see how it runs now, right? Our intention is to get the HTML data. Okay, so I am, one second, it's already launched, so I did not close it earlier, so it's giving a problem. So this kind of mistakes are good for us for debugging purpose. So let me save this again, and let me run this. If you can see here, it is typing the URL, entering it, it will wait, it is trying to read, and then terminated. If you see here, the HTML data is here. If you see here, if I, once I highlighted, all the HTML data we are getting, the complete HTML data we are getting into the variable. But the problem we are seeing is, we thought of seeing only the value, but the tags are coming into this. So we need to use another action here. So instead of get HTML data, we will use get current value. Current value, not the HTML, we want the value inside it. Okay. So I am saving this now. Let me run this once again. If you see here, the browser got closed, right? So I am running it once again. So it will launch it, click, select A, and then type the URL, enter, wait for some time, and then read the data, and then close the browser. So it's got terminated. But if you see here, the HTML data, now we are having only the, just the values. Current value, if you see here, New York 41 degrees, real feed 40 degrees, and then clear. So this is how we can read a HTML data from a browser, and then we can store it in a variable. So I can rename it as get weather or get temperature. I will say this. So this is our action now. So this is not called as a page. So this is an action. So this is one action where we are accessing an application, getting the temperature, and then storing it in a variable. So we can, I think you know, right, input output parameters which you have seen earlier, where this HTML data can be sent as an output for this action. That's, we can do it here. So we will just see in next videos, we will see how we can use this data, and then how we can use this action in part of process, and then we will proceed further. Hope you have understood. Keep watching our videos. Keep learning.